pick up where we left off. Drawing some hidden lines as well as the side view. So let's go ahead and finish drawing this front view. And then we're going to turn these into a section. Do my projection lines. I'm projecting all these lines to show the bottom of the center of the egg crate. Here, I see that goes right down to the middle and then back up. So all I gotta do is take my triangle, and make a hidden line that represents the separation between the egg crates, this area here. And later, we're about to make that a section as soon as we finish our side view. So now, that's pretty much it. Let me do the tabs. Let's measure the tabs out. Tabs are dead center on the 1, 2, 3, so right between 2 and 3, the tabs are dead center, and they're 5/8. So we go dead center, we have a center line there, and then we go up from the middle 3/8, so that represents the bottom of the tab, the height of the tab. 3/8. So that represents the top of the tab. And now we need to make the width of the tab. Now 5/8 was the total width. I need to split the difference. So that means bit more. One more 1/16. That would be a half. Now one more 1/16. So notice I'm just measuring, making sure 5/8 is my width. Let's double check that, because it's supposed to be 5/8 on either side. So really I should stop here and here. This is why we're using light pencils. So now I make projection lines where I made those marks. And I'm only going to do this on one side for now, because when we cut the section here in a second, you'll see why we don't need to show it on the other side. Okay, so that's the beginning of the tab. Now if we project that line down, we need to show that tab in the top view. So when you look down at the top view, like that, we're showing this tab right here, this portion. So that's just going to be located in the center. And we want to kind of measure that width, eyeball that width that you get. It's It's going to be a little odd because you just want to measure what it looks like vertically when you look straight down. So you want to measure as though you're looking from here to there. So that's only about an eighth of an inch. 3/16 we could go with. And it's halfway, so if we got about a half inch border, I'm gonna find the center, and then I go either side. And that is going to be 3/16 what the tab looks like when you look down on it. Alright. Now there is a tab inside of that. I usually inset this about an eighth of an inch. Or you could do a 1/16, but it looked like it was about an eighth. And eighth inch here. Move on to our side view. Side view is going to show this, right? What we're looking at when we look at these three. So, let's start with our projection lines. I'm going to do my big projection lines all the way over. Projecting my base for my section, or the ground plane. So let's go ahead and measure. We're going to block out this little area real quick so we know where we want to stop at with our drawing. So I'm going to do some quick measuring to see what my total width is. My total width was 6 inches. So I'm going to measure. I'm going to pick a point over here. It's okay where you want to choose. I usually start a half inch over, but it's up to you. So I'm going to go 6 inches from here. And that would be there. So this is the new boundary. The height, we have the height. There's our height. Now, let's put our block in that shows our maximum height, maximum width. All right, so that represents the total block out for that space, for that side view. Now, we want to take and we want to do our projection lines in this manner. We want to show our projection lines down from the edge because this corner is that corner. We want to take this line and go all the way down as well. So now what we're starting to do is block in our projection lines to transfer from the top view. then there's this one crucial part where you create that folding plane where we transfer our projection lines from the top view to the top to the side view. Right here is where we're going to start transferring these. Clean these up. In fact, I need to take so this half inch transfers over from that half inch. Now the trick was, I need to make sure I've come over my 6 inches from this side. So really, my boundary is right here. Okay, and that's why we're using light pencil. Once again, I can't stress that enough. So now let's go back, add this vertical projection line. Continue our horizontal, project over this, even project your center line. Alright, now we want to fill in this view. Let's take our... So this view is going to start from this line over to this line. Okay? Now remember, we have this top portion right here, which you can use a projection line, or you can go back to our half inch rule, right? We had about a half inch here. Continuing my projection lines. Because this side also has the lip and the containers and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so I'm drawing the egg carton right in here. It's going to sit just like that. Like that. Okay. Now let's measure the center. Always want to show your center. All right. And then we follow the same rules as the previous French curve, right? We can go back, we know that this egg is in the middle, right? If we sit that there, we know that that is going to fall in the middle, this center egg. So, using the same logic that we had over here, we can get our French curve. And remember, we had it marked in a certain area. And we have our flat area, so let's make that. My flat area was 3/4 of an inch. Then, what we need to do is just split the difference. For all of our center lines. So, over here, I had 1 1/8, so I'm going to go 1 1/8 over again. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. And then I do my half inch rule, or wait, what did I do here? 3/4 inches, so. Okay, now let's go back and make sure I got my center lines for my eggs. Now, the last things are showing these lips, right? These were about an eighth of an inch over. All right, so we want to come here, do that, same thing here, and then remember those kind of connect at the top. So measure 1/8 over here. So now that represents the top portion of the egg carton, as though we're looking right here. Right, we just shown that. All right, now let's add these bottom portions. So we've measured our eighth here, we've got our eighth here. Now we just need to bring back that French curve. Remember where we kinda had it. I had mine about there. So I'm gonna take and make a light mark. Right, and that's going to tell me to come over here. Oops, I need my midpoints. Get those. Got to have your points where your center line of these are going to hit up here, right? These curves are hitting both sides right there, 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 and there. Now let's go back. So that covers that side. Now, the next thing we need to do, we have our side view. Let's project our lines over for our title for our side view so that we have a nice clean layout. I'm going to place that title just down here underneath it. Right, and this is called views are done. Now, the key is to take each of these two views and we're going to turn them into a section. So the first thing we want to do, cutting plane lines. We want to do our cutting plane lines. So I'm going to go ahead and pretend like I'm doing this exact section right here. So we're going to show a section cut there and we're going to show a section cut there. Okay. The first one is going to be partial. We're going to show a cut looking this direction since it's a half section. So, on top of our center line, copying the same exact line type, taking your heavy bold marker, you want to do a section line, cutting plane line, as follows, tracing that center line. Okay, then once you make that, you want to add your arrows, because what we're going to do is we're going to look, we're cutting this way and we're looking that way. So you want to point an arrow straight and draft the whole arrow. And we're going to call this A. Okay? Now, the second one we want to do is we want to draw the other section line going this way, following the same centerline pattern. And we want to point that, oops, I went out of my border. I'll white that out here in a second. We want to point that arrow this way. And that's going to be B. Okay, and that's going to be this section over here. We're going to take a portion of that. So right now we're going to take this half and make it look like a section. Now before we do that, we need to go back and look at why is this not right, or is it right? And what we need to add these little connectors, right? There's actually little connectors between each of these. So what you've got to do is get your circle template. And you're going to connect, or you could use your elliptical template, and you're going to connect these . Now what that looks like is the outside of the egg crate, right? That's kind of what we have there. We could go so far as to draw these guys if we wanted to, right? That would look just like that. If we wanted to show that, it would be this part, right? And we could take and measure from that center line we have right here over and come down and around. In fact, let's just do one example of that, just to clarify. So that width is 1 inch, depth is 1/4 inch. So from this center line, it's 1 inch. Right, and it comes down from the middle line, it comes down about 3/4 inch. That puts it just actually a little less than that. 1/4 inch down. And then what that leaves us, and how wide did we say it was? It's 1 inch wide. Now, what we're looking at here, this comes down and hits the edge of the circle. So then what we do is we take our triangle, Now let's transfer all those angles over. We said that was 1 inch, so let's go back to our middle line over here. Project our lines over. And then do our 45 down. Now on this side, we only want to do half of one of these. So I'm going to go over a half inch instead of the full. And remember, we come down a quarter inch. Then we go over. And then the next part is our 45. All right, so, and we'll do the same over here. But now I want to move on to the sections. So we've shown our section cuts. Now we're going to show this as though it's being cut open. This side is done, pretty much. We're going to come back afterwards and darken in the lines that matter. But over here, we just need to show what it looks like inside here. Okay, so we're showing all of this stuff. So now I'm going to take my heavy pen, and I'm going to go back and darken all of these lines. Now, when I go to the center line, I'm only showing half. Right? Because that point right there stops right there. Then the carton picks back up. So let's go back and make that even more bold. I don't even like it. That needs to pop out even more. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Now we're going to take our Sharpie and do the same thing as we did on the French curve on the bottom. So we're going to find that magic curve. Well, first we want to darken the base. So let's take our triangle. Darken those lines that are hitting the ground. Then we take our French curve. This is where if your tools start getting dirty, we'll get you some stuff to clean it with so you don't get it everywhere. But it's gonna happen. So now we've shown that cut. Now, we're not quite done. We're going to do the same on the other side. I also want you to have, you need to have a ground plane that's pretty well pronounced, so we're going to take and strike a heavy line across this entire base for the side and the front. And now, since we've done that, now we can take, and we can make this a half section, right? Because we're going to show half of this, right? This portion comes over, comes up, and we're going to show this being cut in half. So, just like before, take our triangle, and we're only going to darken half of this. French curve. Now we only want that half there. Let's flip and do the other side. I'm going to beef up the bottom here where the egg carton touches the ground. All right. Now, I have everything darkened that needs to be darkened. There's no other heavy lines until we start showing these drawings better. So now, what you need to show, we need to show what's going on inside these eggs. There's a little lip that goes up and turns back down, right? There's this little lip right here, and we need to show that. So we go back to our center line. Measure our total width. We know it's in the center, and we've got 3/4 of an inch, right? Which just happens to be the base. Happens to be the base of our eggs. So we can just take this line, transfer it up, only in the section area. From these points, right, what we're showing is this contour here. We're showing that. So I just need to drop down whatever height I get, right? And I get 1/4 inch. So I'm going to measure 1/4 inch on these two sides. We're going to just strike that line across there. Now, the next part is you're going to take your ellipse template or your circle template, and you're going to find the best curve for that area. Ellipses look better on that, so we'll do ellipses. something that fits. You know, we need to make sure it's staying in that zone there. Now, the last one is much more pointy and looks different. All right, so that one, the last one actually does something like, now I'm going to darken what we were just discussing. Only in the section view. Alright, this pops back up here. Then I need to show another. So we're darkening this. And there's your complete section view showing the inside of this portion. And you're going to do the exact same steps up here to show this side. But you may notice one difference, right? We can show this cut through the middle, or we can show it as is right here. All right. Good luck.